Welcome back to another video. If you're new to my channel, welcome. For this video, I'm going to be testing out a Vetsy poly gel kit. So this is what the packaging looks like, super cute. And then the kit comes with, of course, a little pamphlet just showing everything that the kit comes with. And then it also came with these nail stickers. So these first ones are just some cows, and then it also has little milk cartons on it, super cute. And then some butterfly stickers, and then there's another set of butterfly stickers that are kind of metallic. And then the last stickers that it came with, I actually used for this nail design, and it's kind of like some cosmic astrology type stickers with like constellations, stars, and moons. It came with these nail tips, which are like long coffin nail tips, but they're not quite long enough for me, so I didn't use them. But if you all are interested in seeing me use these, then I would be willing to do that. I've used nail tips like this in the past. These are like the first floor cover nail tips that came out like years ago, and everybody went crazy for them. But yeah, y'all know I prefer the long nails. It also came with some dual forms, which again, if you guys want to see me use some poly gel in dual forms, let me know and I will try it out. You also get some rhinestones. Half of these are AB, and then the other ones are just these white stones or like the silver stones. It also came with some tweezers that you can use to kind of like just get the stickers off of the paper and stuff. But yeah, I love the fact that this came with some rhinestones. I love when a nail kit has rhinestones in it. I don't know, I just feel like it adds something to it. It also came with base coat and top coat, of course. Those are essential. And then it did come with slip solution, which I don't typically use, but I did use it in this video and I actually really liked it. It came with some paper forms, which again, if you're interested in seeing me use paper forms and poly gel, let me know. I do have a previous video where I used that, so I'll leave that up in the cards if you're interested in seeing it. It didn't really turn out that great, but it was all right. You also get this little set of foils, which I am going to use in this design. And then these glitter mixes, which are super pretty. They remind me of the glitter mixes from the Macart Ocean Couture Kit. These are some little caviar beads, which I do plan on using in another design. I am going to use this kit again. So yeah, stay tuned for that. I might do it next week. It also came with a 100-180 grit file, a little nail clamp to like hold the nail in place. And then this cuticle oil. I think this one is the rose scent. But yeah, just a cuticle oil pen. I've been getting a lot of these in a lot of kits lately. And then of course the poly gel brush. So I'm just going to go ahead and swatch all of the colors. These swatches weren't really the best, but I haven't really swatched any poly gel in a while. So yeah, I just put out all of the colors, and I really do love the colors that come with this kit. I think they're super pretty, but these are the classic colors. So if you already have these colors, you may feel like you don't really need this kit. I went ahead and cured my swatches in the lamp, and then I just went in with some peel off base coat while that was curing. If you wanted to do your nails like this using the Femi Beauty method and you wanted them to last for about 2 weeks, you can go in and file your nails and then go in with some dehydrator and primer and put a thin coat of base coat gel on your nails, cure that in the lamp, and then go on with the rest of the process. But if you just wanted to practice and play around with it, then I would recommend using a peel off base coat so that way you can just pop them right off. But I'm just starting right now with the pinky, and I just put a layer of base coat gel inside of the nail, and then I'm going in with this paint glitter mix, and I'm doing somewhat of like an S shape. And once I have that in the nail how I want it, I'm just going to pop that in the lamp to cure that into place. While I'm doing that, here's my featured comment. Thank you so much, Makeup Shay, for your comment on my previous video. I really appreciate it. But now I'm going behind the nail with the poly gel. So I'm using white and the clear glitter, and I'm just taking the spatula end of the poly gel brush and I just dipped it in the slip solution, and then I'm just using it to kind of marble out the design. So yeah, I used these two colors because I wanted like that milky marble look, and I think it turned out super pretty. So yeah, once I have it fully marbled out, I'm just going to go behind it with a little bit more of the clear color just so that I can fill up the nail, because these nail tips do have somewhat of a high apex, so you will have to make sure you're putting a good amount of poly gel inside of it. Now I'm going on to the ring finger and I'm applying some base coat gel inside of the nail because I'm going to use that to adhere my gold foil and my glitter. So I'm going to go in and apply the gold foil first, and I'm going to do two slanted lines in the nail and kind of leave a space in the middle. For the middle of the nail, I'm going to have my marble, so I'm going to be adding some of the glitter at the tip and at the bottom, and then leave some space in the middle between the two gold foil lines for the marble poly gel. Hopefully that makes sense, but you'll see what I'm doing. Once I have that in, I'm just kind of turning it around just to check and see how it looks from the front. And I'm just going to continue to play around with it, get my two gold foil lines how I want it, and then apply the glitter. Once I have that applied, I'm going to cure that in the lamp, and then you'll see me go behind it and apply the poly gel. Now that I have my marble done, I haven't cured it in the lamp. I'm just going to go in and apply some clear on top of the two glitter portions of the nail. And then I'm just going to use the poly gel brush to just smooth that out and drag it towards where the marble is in the middle. And then I'm just going to press it onto my nail and cure it in the lamp. For the middle finger, I'm going to be repeating the same steps, but I'm going to be doing the lines in the opposite direction so that way when you put the nails together, then it kind of looks like they're together, if that makes sense, like the two marble pieces in the middle will line up. So the gold foil will be going to the opposite side. For this nail, I'm doing the same thing that I did on the pinky. So I'm applying some base coat gel inside of the nail. I'm going to use that to adhere my glitter in somewhat of an S shape. And then I'm going to go behind it with my two poly gel colors and use the spatula end of the brush to just kind of marble it out. I did end up having to go back and add a little bit of clear poly gel behind this nail also, just to make sure it was nice and full. But you can kind of eliminate having to go back and add that by just adding enough poly gel to begin with. But yeah, sometimes you don't add it enough and you just have to add a little bit more just to fill up the nail. For the thumb, I'm going in with some base coat gel and I'm going to use that to apply my gold foil. So I'm going to put some in the top corner of the nail and then I'm going to also put some on the opposite bottom corner of the nail. I'm going to cure that in the lamp and then I'm going to go behind it with my poly gel and just do my regular marble design. But I absolutely love the way that this set turned out. It kind of reminded me of another set that I did that was like a cosmic Sailor Moon set. So if you're interested in seeing that, I'll leave it linked in the cards. But yeah, this just kind of gives me like astrology vibes, like Milky Way vibes, if that makes sense. But yeah, I'm just going in with the poly gel now and I'm going to smooth that out and just apply the nail. I also wanted to mention, not too long ago I got a comment about using, I think it was acrylic or either poly gel on top of a press on nail, and the person was saying how when they tried to do it they kept losing the nail shape. I would recommend, instead of putting poly gel or acrylic on top of a full cover nail, you could always just do the Femi Beauty method, but just put on peel off base coat when you're applying it, so that way you can just pop it off and use it as press ons. So let's say you're like me and you have trouble using your non-dominant hand to do your other hand, you could just go ahead and do both sets on one hand, pop them off and just glue them back on, but that way you still have your poly gel nails. But yeah, to go along with my Milky Way cosmic astrology vibe, I decided to go in and apply these nail stickers, but unfortunately my phone ended up running out of storage space, so I don't have all of the footage. But once I applied the stickers, I just went over it with top coat gel and then I also top coated the underside of the nail. But you could go in and just wipe them off with alcohol or slip solution. But this is how the set turned out. I absolutely love it. Also, I'm just curious, if you voted on my community tab for this design, please let me know in the comments down below if this is what you expected to see. Also, for everyone who voted for the other design, I will be doing that soon, so definitely stay tuned for that. And if you have no idea what I'm talking about, make sure you subscribe to my channel and press that notification bell so that you're always notified when I upload, and that way you'll see my community tab post and you'll be able to vote in my polls to help me decide what nail design to do. But thank you all so much for watching. I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye.